Hey guys, this is Vivi here. Thank you so much for stopping by my channel. Today, I'm going to introduce an educational puzzle game called While to Learn. The name already looks very geek. Through the game, you will learn about the history of machine learning, big data, AI, and some very fundamental programming knowledge and logic. The features in the game are cats, modules,programming, machine learning, AI, they combine together in a very smart and interesting way. Today, let's see how professional we can be after playing this game. This thing is so noisy, I need to take it off. So the game starts from the player wants to understand what his cat is speaking. Then he went onto the website and asked, and some guru told him some information and passed on some jobs. And the game starts from here. To understand the cats, you will need to be able to recognize the cat's shape, learn their facial expressions, and get more cats involved in so you will have more samples, just like what we do nowadays to do machine learning things. And basically, it is talking about the fundamentals of machine learning, then neural networks, big data, and lastly AI. It talks about the history of the whole thing, as early as 1935, when everything started, to the AI as the current date. Yeah, this game is serious, not joking around. Some information it provides are very basic, but I never heard of them before. Very interesting to know that.Each level is a job that is referred from someone somewhere. You can tell those jobs are fake since the names and logic are made up and there are some puns, some silly stories, mocking, but in some way they also look realistic. You can see some ideas through them and you can tell it could totally happen in the real world. Except for the jobs, you can use your knowledge to invest in a startup, build an algorithm andlet it run automatically, then just get money day by day. Well, there is a chance that you will get bankrupt if you don't manage it well. So here's how to play. In each level, you will need to assemble the modules to sort and filter the data on the left side, which has three colors and three shapes according to the output requirements on the right side. The modules are different algorithms. The game will introduce the modules as the story moves on. It covers the very early and basic ones, the decision tree, then the regression tree, then to neural networks, deep learning, then to the AI. Basically, I guess every essential one for machine learning. And they offer related articles and videos for you to explore on your own. When I was playing, I hardly feel it is just like a game, like those puzzle logic games. But when I got stuck sometimes,And I just went to search for some related knowledge about the algorithms and tried them in the game. It's a little difficult for me to relate the algorithm, in the real world onto this game, but somehow it works pretty well. Here's an example using some geek language. What I learned from searching is that the algorithm module decision tree, which is the most basic one we use in the game, and I guess also in the real world we use it a lot. So in the real world, it will only do a simple yes or no decision, but in the game, it doesn't work like that. The color decision tree, if you choose to separate red and blue color, the red output will get red and green. Blue output will get blue and green. It's not a yes or no answer. So it's a little tricky to relate the real with the game. And the final output always requires different colors and shapes. It's not a simple yes or no situation. But in some way, it made me feel very realistic because in the real world, we don't always need a yes or no or this or that result. The programmers just need to find a way to apply and combine the simple yes or no decision tree to achieve different needs to get more complicated and various results. Another realistic thing in the game is you need to beat the time and use modules within a limit to get a gold medal. I feel that I did need to observe the original data set and calculate the processing time, and after some searchings, I will consider the genie to calculate the efficiency and try to optimize the whole process. I was arranging the modules and did testing all the time, just like what a programmer will do in the real life. It's tricky to apply the knowledge from the real world into the game since it looks very different, but surprisingly, I got it worked. I hope it's not just because I'm lucky. I hope it's because I fully understood how the developers set the mechanism. And another realistic thing about the game is the money in the game, you can use it to upgrade your hardwares to improve the data processing speed, increase the capacity, and so, which is just like what we do in the real world. So some early levels, sometimes you just can't beat the time. But after upgrading the equipment, you just run the program again and you could get a gold medal easily. And the balancer in the game could separate the data, which is like the server in the real world that you will need to rent. You could also buy some decals that do nothing but entertainment and increase your happiness. Another thing that impressed me a lot in the game is it made me think about the reality. Sometimes you don't need to get a high accuracy or you need to get everything correct. So I will consider the samples needed and processing time and the server rental fee that eventually I might decide to abandon some data, such as a candy factory. If it's in the real world, abandon the data means throw away the candies. That means waste. But by discarding some candies, it will increase the speed and get a higher accuracy. So I'm thinking maybe this is where the waste and processing fee come from. So a better algorithm or equipment will be able to help with it. Technology will change a life. If you only play the game, it's a very short game. It took me about a week or so to finish since I played and learned from other sources at the same time. I felt I'm part of this field after playing this game. For sure, I can't be a machine learning guru after playing this game, but this high-tech thing doesn't look that far away to approach. It's a very, very nice tool to help you to step into this field. And it's not only just bring you there, it will also lead you to some deeper learnings by offering many resources, and it is super helpful and thoughtful to get those links. If you would like, you can just directly step forward based on this game. This game is on mostly every main platforms. I bought the iPad version, which I don't recommend you. I have some troubles dragging and selecting. I assume the Switch version might have the similar issues. So get a Steam version to play on PC or Mac if you could, just use a mouse. The prices are different. iPad version is only $5 and Switch and Steam version is $13. Maybe there will be some more functions on content. I really love the concept of the game. It's for adults, but still using a format as a game to turn the boring learning process to some interesting knowledge. The mechanism is rather addictive, and the dialogues and puns always make me laugh. It is not as hard as a hardcore game. It's helpful for those who want to start learning about machine learning, since it has so many related links. To those who just want to generally know about machine learning, the game does contain enough information. I hope there will be more games like this on the market that will make you learn while playing, that will make you think. I will keep trying to find this kind of games and introduce them to you. If you have some recommendations, please comment below, share it with me and other audience. Alright, that's it for today's video. Thank you so much for watching. If you like my video or my channel, please consider giving me a thumbs up or just checking out my channel and subscribing. Alright, that's it. I will see you guys soon in my future videos. Bye.